Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Nick here at Douglas Elliman Real Estate. Just want to give you a quick update on a couple things, but we're going to specify, or I'm going to specify one, and this is Rainy Street. If y'all are in Austin, Texas, I'm sure you know about Rainy Street. If you are not in Austin, Texas, and you're moving to Austin, Texas, it's something to pay attention to. So Rainy Street is right over here. I mean, I can literally see it from where I'm at. And it is a new development, newish in Austin, although there's so many. This is a pretty much one street, Rainy Street, you know, and there's a new, pretty much every new kind of restaurant here. I mean, pizza, Italian, type of food truck. Very high-end, wonderful condominiums with everything you can possibly want. All right. So Rainy's rising up. I remember seeing this property or this street, I guess, about, I don't know, 15 years ago, and there was nothing there. There were a bunch of old Austin houses, like the small craftsman style houses that you'd see everywhere and that you still see everywhere, especially on the east side. And as this being east of Congress, it was the east side. Now, over the years, this is something I told Diane. I was like, you're going to see this become a booming district. This, no one's paying attention to it. And some other real estate developers had the same idea. And now you have Rainy Street. Now, so as Rainy Street has been developing for the past 10, 15 years, it's getting even better. All right. So even the properties that are there, the monster condos, the excellent eateries and coffee shops and anything else you want. This is right next to downtown. It's a little pocket of downtown. So if you're not familiar with it, check it out. It's Rainy, R-A-I-N-E-Y Street in 78701. All right, so here's the story. So Austin's revamping a lot. This is a really great example of it, although it's been in action for a few years, as you'll see. If you come and visit Austin, let me know. We can go and get the best food and whatnot. All right, so yeah, as I said, it's a small corner downtown, seeing a large share of the local growth that's bringing significant opportunities and challenges to the area. So here are the challenges. So it used to be a queer area. Like I said, there was nothing there, just those small craftsman-style houses, and it was residential. Now it's an urban sector brimming with high-rises, thriving entertainment district, of course, and, you know, it's right by the lake, too. All right, so literally, if you're just walking along the lake and, or you're walking down Rainy Street and you want to go check out the lake, you can. It's within walking distance. Parking's a challenge. I suggest taking Uber because it's super highly popular, but it is highly walkable. All right. There's a great museum there. This is open during the day. There's a lot of nightlife. More of the nightlife is really going on right now. Of course, the restaurants generally are open the day. The ones that are brick and mortar are open during the day, but they're not many of those because they're all in these old houses. They're all converted from old houses into restaurants and bars and clubs and stuff like that. It's pretty impressive. So the effects of all this, the local change has driven everybody out that lives there. There are a few standing homes that they're not selling. These people are steadfast, and I admire that courage, because especially with the value of what Rainy Street has produced, that their home is worth well. I think it's probably a family thing, you know, they're like, you know, my kids need this. You know, it's very important to invest in real estate because your financial portfolio is heavily, or should be heavily, invested in real estate. And if you look at the wealthiest people in the world, most of their wealth is wrapped up in real estate. This is very important, and this is really cool. So the folks that decide to buy charging exorbitant amounts of rent, you know, to run their businesses and for good cause, because the amount of people that are down there are pretty impressive. So it's not the same as it was 20, 30 years ago. It's definitely hugely different, and I'm looking right now at a map of it. And I tell you what, so there's a rush on Rainy. The profile has already moved vertically, of course, on those I was referring to. But the stakeholders in the area said that the peak of development with more than 4 million square feet of new construction underway. 4 million square feet bigger than our convention center. Convention center here in Austin, Texas is enormous, very impressive, and it's also expanding too. That's another whole story I'll tell you about later. So there's a lot of new projects that are running through there. All right. There is an underground tunnel that's running through there, and I won't get into the details about that because I don't know exactly what the details. Pretend like I know what I'm talking about on that matter. But they do have this really cool museum there. It's the Mexican American Cultural Center, and that's right on the lake as well. That's been there. That was been there. That was where way before all these restaurants, and that's worth a look. There's always an event there. And this is Texas, y'all. If you're in Austin, Texas, that's definitely, certainly a place that you want to visit. And it's right downtown, so it's real close to all the hotels and everything you need. So again, I'm looking at this. It really becomes a bit more focused on the real estate goal of this video is around Rainy Street, all right? Of course, Rainy Street is going to always be a draw. Downtown is always going to be a draw. Downtown is obviously established. Rainy is relatively new, but if you're looking to move here, all right, if you're looking for a condo that has every single amenity that you could possibly want, and especially if you're lucky enough to work at home or get a sweet job downtown, because there are many people hiring and they sure want people back in the office. But if you're like a software engineer, freelance organizer, consultant, or something like that, then you're going to be right at home anywhere. However, if you want the hustle and bustle and not have to drive, downtown Austin's where it's at. Now, I'll get into more of that, but they're like self-driver cars, there are automatic robots delivering food down here. It's crazy. All right, so I'll tell you a couple of your options, several of your options, not a couple. All right, so the water line is new. This is a 74-story building. This is on Red River. So Red River is right over here, and this runs parallel to I-35, and it is a huge entertainment district. And one thing about Red River is there's actually a lot of parking. You got the Bass Concert Hall runs right next to the University of Texas, and pretty much every venue that you could want, whether you want pizza or you want to listen to punk rock music, all right, it's on Red River, and that's I don't know, it's a really nice property. So you got the Travis on Red River as well. Same story, same amenities, very, very nice. I'm talking about 24-hour security, parking, everything. And these are a couple examples of just how magnificently this city, the COA, is pretty much accommodating all these developers in these huge buildings. And I tell you what, like, so I'm looking right now at the capital of Texas, and I-35 is right here, but when you're driving south down I-35, or even driving north down I-35, the skyline of Austin, Texas has changed so dramatically. It's beautiful, it really is. I mean, this is a true metropolitan city, and you can tell that, but it's also really accommodating to the people that want to live here and work here. All right, I digress as usual. We got the Modern. This is on Davis Street. This is a hugely, you have to check this out. All right, again, this is the Modern. All right, it says Modern. That's kind of like devaluing what it is. It's one of the most luxurious buildings I've been in downtown Austin. You got the Vesper, which is really cool. Attended a birthday party that was Vesper themed, and if you remember James Bond, you'll know what I'm talking about. And whenever you talk about perfection and James Bond and what Vesper is, this is a really, really spot, okay? And this is all in the area of town, that South Pocket near Rainy Street, okay? So we got Paseo as well, and that one is on Rainy Street. Paseo, again, is very palatial, larger units, I suppose. A little bit more expensive, but I'll tell you what, it's worth it. And all these ones I've mentioned to you, concierge, they have 24/7 security. Downtown is where it's at. Travis Heights, right? Travis Heights is absolutely fantastic. That was eclectic originality of Austin, Texas. with a touch of, I guess, the elegance, I suppose, of old South Austin as well. It's just not as compact as downtown, but you can walk from Travis Heights here. I do it all the time. All right, we do have the Cambria. This is a hotel, but they do have residences as well. And this is, again, it's all around Raining Street. We have 700 River, so that's 7th Street and River. And those are pretty much the top-notch ones that we have, but if you're trying to get around, there's an economic and cultural boom is not without some problems, however. So if you own a space, let's say, for example, at the Shore condominiums, right over here, it's almost unlivable because, you know, waiting in the area to like get transportation or find a parking spot is really a big problem, right? Austin, Texas has some measures working on, some arguable, some problems that they have with how the city of Austin is going to manage elements based on parking. All right, so that's another thing. There's a video, if you haven't seen the video on that, check that out. Do you have any questions about the parking issue, whether it be in downtown or 78704, or specifically Travis Heights, let me know. All right, Diane and I are your real estate advisors, and we are always standing by to help you out with questions, anything you need, all right? And of course, you're gonna get updates on a regular basis, but that's Rainy Street today, and I'll always throw in Travis Heights because that's my stomping grounds, and it's right there, and I love that. This is a great place to be as well, even in downtown, but you know, honestly, it's because I could walk home right now. It's close enough. But I tell you what, Rainy Street's great, Travis Heights is great, downtown is great, any other condo in Austin, Texas, you can count on our team to take care of this because we stand by all the time, and Diane and I are your real estate advisors. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.